Hello all. So, as a continuation of the sheet metal operations, in this video we are going to see about how the deep drawing process is done. Deep drawing is also a type of sheet metal operation. So, deep drawing, it is mostly done in the automotive industries for manufacturing the car body parts. So, it is used in most of the automotive industries. So the process, the deep drawing is a process of a forming which occurs under a combination of tensile and compressive conditions. So we know either the compressive forces acts or the tensile force acts. Here in this deep drawing process, both compressive and tensile forces it acts together. A flat sheet metal blank is formed into a hollow body on one side, or a hollow body is formed into a hollow body with a smaller cross section. Deep drawing process, it is divided into three types. One is deep drawing with tools, deep drawing with active means, and deep drawing with active energy. In automotive industry, deep drawing is usually carried out using rigid tools. So this is how a deep drawing process is carried out. Either a flat piece is converted into a hollow one, a hollow one is converted into a hollow with a smaller cross section. So here the sheet metal is placed below that is the die of the required shape, and a punch attached with a binder is placed. So when the forces acts on the punch it moves towards the sheet metal and it deforms the sheet metal to the required shape of the die. So the diagram one, it shows the blank sheet metal. In the second one, the punch is moved towards the sheet metal. Here a little force is given so that it deforms in a little way, and in the final one, the final component, the final shape of the required sheet metal is obtained. The figure illustrates the deep drawing process. The rigid tool consists of a punch, die and a binder. In deep drawing, the plate holder closes after metal sheet blank has been inserted. The sheet is clamped between die and the binder. This process slows down the flow of the sheet while it is being drawn and thereby prevents the wrinkles. When it is tied together, there is no wrinkles forming under the binder. The punch stretches the sheet over the die radius and forms it into the die. The amount of a punch force necessary for forming is thereby continually increased by up to the lower dead center of the punch. Whereas pure deep drawing, there is no reduction of sheet metal thickness. Forming is achieved by stretching purely as a result of a decrease in the sheet metal thickness. Stretch forming is extensively used for the forming of slightly curved parts like roofs, doors, etc. So here is a video of how the deep drawing process takes place in the industries. This video shows about how the deep drawing process takes place inside a industry. So this is the deep drawing equipment machine. So only a very less amount of material is reduced in this deep drawing process. So here you can see the die. The sheet metal is placed, and this is the punch. So more number of components can be produced with the help of this deep drawing process. So you can observe here, already we know that deep drawing process, either it produces, makes a blank one into a rolled component, or the hollow component of a smaller cross section. So in this video, step by step, the cross section of the workpiece is getting reduced. you can observe that. So in each stage the cross section of the workpieces keep on reducing. And after the process, the workpieces, final pieces collected. So we kept a plain one, and this is for the pen. This a pen can be manufactured. So anything of this shapes like a inhaler, everything can be produced with the help of this deep drawing. Even the motor casing, all these things can be produced with the help of a deep drawing process. And the next one is about what are the metals in. It's not that everything can be done in every metal. So there are some restrictions for the metals that can be used in a deep drawing. So these are the metals that can be used to manufacture the products through deep drawing. So it can be an alloy, aluminium, bronze, copper, cold rolled steel, invar, iron, coir, molybdenum, nickel, silver, stainless steel and tungsten. So these are some of the materials that can be used to produce their components through a deep drawing process. So this is about the deep drawing process. Thank you.